What's up, everybody? What's up, TJ? We're outside the store right now. We're just waiting for Mr. Peak to arrive. What's up? Good morning. Good morning, everybody. I don't want to go in too early, so I'm gonna wait for him to show up. What's up? What's up? Yeah, we're right outside the store. Morning, Slow Tech. Morning. Said he should be here in a minute. Said 10:05. He's got 1 minute. He's late, I know. Chris is always like, he made me drive 40 minutes away and he ends up being late. That's Chris for you right there. He should be here in a minute though. I think he's pulling in right now. What's up, Trisha? Storm the gates. Yeah, everybody already went inside. It actually opened like 2 minutes late. I thought, dang, he might actually get here. Appreciate you, Kelly. My sellers passed away and I struggle and need help. Thanks for the content. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. But I appreciate you watching. What's up, Celeste? What's up, Adam? We got some legendary resellers in the chat. And then Chris is flicking me off right now. You sent a notification. Thanks for already grabbing stuff. I know. I'm hanging outside. I think he's watching. What's up, everybody? Got 424 people in here. We're about to get in the store right now. We're just waiting for Chris's late self. Look at him. Look how slow this guy is. He's still dicking around in his car. Like, look at this. He's like 6 minutes late and he's like checking his car 14 times. What's up? I'm just telling chat you're a little late.
It's all right. I'm gonna get some, doesn't matter at the store.
No.
Ready? I'll get some quick.
You want to see some content being made in action? He's acting like he's walking up to the store right now. He dropped his keys. This is a professional. It's a professional.
What's up?
All right, let's get in the store. Professional. Are you going live or are you just gonna thrift?
More like professional.
Professional.
Yeah, I'll go live.
All right, Chris is gonna go live too. Holy cow. I've never been in this store. Oh, we got a broken cart. I'll let Chris have this one. Behind the scenes. I guess we'll look at the shoes first. Yeah, this is the one on Nebraska. I've never been to the store. A pair of Ultra Boosts, but they're pretty beat. Got Nike Shocks. 13 for them. That's a little too much. A little too much for my blood. Does anybody know if this is a good brand? Inov. I might have to look this one up. It's always good to just throw it in your cart. Are these Allbirds? Allbirds for $12.99. That might be too much. Throw them in the cart though. Brooks. $13 too much for Nikes. Yeah, not for those shocks. Plus, I never list my shoes, so I need to get shoes that I'll sell quick that I'll actually list. Another pair of Nikes down there. Steph Curry's. I don't know what they want for these, but these are... Zero brands. I'll throw those in the cart too. I don't see anything else there. Let's see what they got for dress shoes. Get the New Balances. Get those A6s. What A6s? Problem is I don't list my shoes. Let's go to the women's. I'll scoot back and come back to the men's. Go to the women's shoes, we'll come back to the men's. Remember, Chris is live too, so if you guys want to go back and forth between both of us, feel free to. He's live in the same store, so you can see what he's picking up versus me. Skechers. Store's pretty expensive on shoes. A lot of their shoes are like $14.99 pretty much. Appreciate the cat claw thingy-ma-bob. Bold North. If you guys aren't following Bold North, he's gonna be right up here. Go give him a follow. Man, this is like an adventure. They have a lot of shoes here, though. They have a lot more than the other store has, that's for sure. But I don't see anything I want to scoop. Just Nike free runs, but they want $13 for them. A pair of Kyries. They want $24.99 for the Kyries, though. Yikes. All right, I'm not seeing anything in the women's section. Not seeing anything else. Let's go to the men's. The music is a bit much. Yeah, I know. Chris actually requested this song. There he's over there. He's over in the men's. He's going through the dress shirts. He's like, I gotta get there before Wayne does. There we go, right off the bat, a pair of 7 for All Mankind, the straight. It's a good one, it's a good pickup. LL Beans. So it's from, a lot listed, okay. Yeah, I'll take a look at them afterwards, after the live. 2 LL Bean jeans here for $7.99. If those were half off, I might consider it. Pair of Carhartts. $10 for Carhartts. What size are they? I might still pick these up. 36. I'll probably still scoop these. Those in. Let's go through the polos next. Short sleeves and polos. Oh, there's a whole nother long sleeve section over here too. Holy cow. This store is massive. What store is this? This is Salvation Army. First time I've ever been to this store, so brand new to me. I don't know the layout. Laughlin. Brooks Brothers. I want $12.99 for Brooks Brothers. A little on the high side. Appreciate you guys hanging out. If you're not following, you know what to do. Hit that follow button top left hand corner. We might be going to another store after this to see what time we get out of here. This is a pretty big store, so I might be in here for a little bit. Vineyard Vines. Size medium. Looks to be in good condition. It's only $7. That's a scoop. Yeah, this music is pretty annoying. I I'm all about the Christmas spirit, but it's a little loud in here. What brand was that? It's Vineyard Vines. Vineyard Vines. Love these lives. Appreciate it. Appreciate you always coming back and watching. This is not the normal store I go to. Chris invited me out on a date day. He said, Wayne, you want to go out on a date? I said, sure. Where do you want to go? Salvation Army. I said, oh, you already knew where I wanted to go. Lucky brand. This might actually be a pickup. This is a Joseph A. Bank 100% silk shirt. I might have to look this one up. I've never seen a Joseph A. Bank Hawaiian shirt before. You guys gonna get some salads after this? Who eats salad? Maybe Chris does. I don't even know a damn salad. I'll eat a burger. If he invites me out for salads after this, date over. Consider this date over. You missed the Brooks Brothers? Yeah, I don't pick up all Brooks Brothers like this one right here. Actually, this one's only $3.99. It's kind of a non-good style, though. I'm probably going to leave it. Maybe Chris will want it. He can come find it. Dated, yeah. Yeah, it's an older style. I don't really pick up too many Brooks Brothers. The ones I pick up are the solid white dress shirts. I sold like 3 solid white dress shirts over the weekend from Brooks Brothers. So those are the ones I'm really looking for. Polo Golf. $7.99 is too much. Too much. I love Brooks Brothers. Yeah, I like picking up certain Brooks Brothers pieces sell really well. It's a polo. Medium for $6.99. I'll pass on that one. Still water supply. It's an army jacket. At least the store has good reception. I was worried. Vintage Wrangler would snap so well for me. I have to make sure I'm not paying too much. Here, like, a lot of these shirts are like 10 bucks, so I got to make sure I'm not paying too much for these. It's not half off day. Tomorrow's half off day, so. Appreciate you guys hanging out too. We've got almost 1,000 people in here. If you're not following, hit that follow button in the top left-hand corner. I do this multiple times throughout the week where I come to thrift stores, retail stores. I buy stuff cheap. I resell it online for a profit. I take you guys with me. So if you're not following, hit that follow button. You get a notification as soon as I go live. Make sure you go through your notifications too and select live and select my name so you definitely will get a notification. Sometimes if you don't do that, it won't send you the notification when I go live. Hold on a second. Sorry, I was messing with my phone. All right. Let's see what else we got in here. Ben Sherman. Yeah, I don't pick up Ben Sherman. Ben Sherman doesn't resell very well. Any other resellers in the Orlando, Florida area? I think Dirty Thrift is in Orlando. Go look her up. She's in Orlando area. So far, I already got some good stuff, so this looks like a good store. Like I said, I've never ever been to this store before, so this is new to me. New thrifting territory. Brevard County here. What's up? Does anybody know if this is good? Haley Henson. It's $7.99. It's an Ocean Power shirt. This has got to be good, right? I'm going to throw it in the cart. That's got to be good. Yeah, okay. I'll let Chris look at it too. I never pick up that brand. People like screamed at me the other day because I missed it in one of my videos. Yeah, it's good. Okay. How do you know it sells well? You can look them up on eBay. You can look up exactly what they're selling for on eBay. Just filter for used, filter for sold, type in the item you're looking at, and can find exactly what they're selling for. Make sure you're also watching Chris is live too. Chris is live in the same store right now. So Chrisatpeak, you guys can shuffle between both of our lives, go back and forth. You can let him know what I pick up. When I get like a $100 item, just like shoot over to his live and say, haha, Wayne's beating you. Make sure if you're not following already, hit that follow button, top left-hand corner. Tap the screen, send the likes, you know what to do, all that good stuff. And if you miss any part of this live, by the way, it will be posted to my YouTube channel afterwards. Go back and pick up the pink polo shirt. I'll tell you this, most of the time, the people that say pick it up, they don't ever Venmo me, so I'm not really worried about it. If you want it, it's here at good old Salvation Army right now. It's a nice Joseph A. But, I don't normally do pickups, live pickups in store. Bergdorf doesn't sell. Up what I think it's going to sell for. It's something that anybody out there could do. LL Bean shirt. Yeah, I don't pick up all LL Beans. What's your Venmo? I don't even know what my Venmo is, to be honest. There's a Tommy Bahama. But yeah, I don't do live pickups. I don't do that. So yeah. Another Tommy Bahama. Those are just plain ones. I don't pick up the plain ones. I left my cart behind. I gotta go grab it in a second. Oh, sorry, I'm not showing the tags. McDonald's shirt. What do we got for solid white dress shirts? Tommy Bahama long sleeve with a stain all over it. That's no good. How many thrift stores do you go per day? Today I'll probably go to two. Two minimum. There's an Orvis shirt. How much do I want for it? It's $8 for an Orvis shirt. This is like a Henley style, and it's 100% linen. I'm gonna pass. If it was half off day, I'd probably pick it up. There we go. Solid white Brooks Brothers for $6.99. As long as this has no stains on it, I will be picking this up. Sell these for right around $30 to $35 pretty quick. How come you don't pick up Columbia brand shirts? They just don't sell well for me. They don't sell fast and they don't sell for good money. So if I'm paying like $7.99 for a Columbia shirt and it's only going to go for like $20, free shipping. There's not enough meat on the bone for me. So I'll leave it behind. Leave it for the next guy. Appreciate everybody hanging out too. Like I always say, if you're not following, you know what to do. Hit that follow button top left hand corner. Also, Chrisatpeak is in the same store as me. So if you guys want to go watch him do a live thrift, he's live thrifting right now as we speak. As we speak, he's at peak, his live stream. Tommy Bahama, they want 10 bucks for it. It's kind of crazy. Does Chris do women's? I don't think Chris does women's. I don't think he does. You guys want me to go like take everything out of his cart and run? How long do you sit on items before you redonate? I normally don't redonate. I'll just keep it listed until it sells. Oh man, thank you. It's a little dusty in here. Here's an Orbis Buzz Off shirt. I'll probably pick this one up. As long as it doesn't have any stains on it. They don't sell for crazy money, but for $6.99, I could probably sell these for like 25 bucks. Do you take it home and wash it? No, the only time I wash items is if they have stains or bad smells. Yeah, I think most items that are donated to thrift stores have already been washed. People just take them out of their closet and they donate them. So most of these items are pretty clean. But and most of the time when people purchase items online that are used, they will wash them as soon as they get them in. Man, this store has so much clothing, it's hard to like go through these racks. Like, it's so tightly packed. It was a Disney shirt. I don't pick up Disney, that kind of Disney shirt, so I'm not even gonna go back and look at it. That's not a vintage shirt, so it's not gonna be worth too much. Sorry, I can't show you guys the labels. It's like so packed. That's a good sign though. That means that there hasn't been a lot of people through these racks. Oh my goodness. Woodward. Fill your cart with... You did jeans already? Yeah, there was only like 10 pairs of jeans on the rack. I found a pair of 7 for All Mankind, and I found a pair of Carhartt jeans. And that was it. Yeah, I should fill my cart, and then I should go over to Chris and be like, dude, I just hit the mother load. You can have it all if you want it. Where do you sell it? I sell on eBay, Poshmark, Mercari, and Facebook Marketplace. Sorry, I'm really trying to show these labels for you guys, but they're so... up for that challenge. But if you are, keep tapping. We got a lot of taps to go. Red rhino. What was the best find you found? My best find in a thrift store. I found a lot of really good items, a lot of $100 items. I found Gucci in a thrift store. I found Peter Millar Masters new tag in a thrift store. Lots of pretty decent finds. This is 100% silk. What size is it? What's the size? Oh, it's a 70% silk. I'll probably leave it. It's nat nast, but it's not 100% silk. I'm trying to be a little selective with the stuff I pick up too, because I got enough inventory as is. I didn't know Norman Rockwell sold Arrowhead shirts. Goodwill is a franchise. Well, I'm not in Goodwill, so clearly, I don't think any Goodwills use those kind of tags. Appreciate all the follows coming in. Thank you guys so much. Make sure you're sharing the live. If you have anybody you think is interested in this kind of stuff, share the live to them.
Now you separate your what you call it.
Tap the screen, send the likes. Nothing so far in this aisle. I thought that might have been a cool shirt. Grab my cart. Slide my cart down. Well, I'm not blocking anybody. American Eagle? No, I don't pick up American Eagle. American Eagle doesn't resell well. It's a good brand, good wearable brand, but doesn't have good resell value. Too watered down. It's like what my Karen video was talking about. There's so many good brands in here that I don't pick up. Like Ralph Lauren, there's two Ralph Laurens right there I'm not gonna pick up. Peter Millar polos. Hopefully we find some, yeah. Haven't gone to the polos yet. All right, that's a pretty bad aisle. Let's go through the pattern polos and then we'll come back. Chris grabbing all the polos? He probably is. He's probably stealing them all. No, he's not even on this side of the store. I don't even know where he's at right now. Oh, he's over here. I don't know what he's going through. Looks like jackets or something. If you guys want to go watch him, Chris is live too as well. Chrisatpeak. Jeans, I've already been there. He's looking at jeans, okay. Oh, there's jean section over there? Okay. I thought there was only one jean section. This is Chris Holmes' home turf. So he's gonna find more than me. This is a RLX polo, but it's got staining all over it, so we're gonna leave it. Sorry, Chris doesn't do women's, so if I run out of men's stuff to look at, you already know I'm going to the women's section. What's Chris's at? Chrisatpeak. One word, Chrisatpeak. Yep, somebody just, Trisha just typed it in the chat. Chrisatpeak. He's right over there. Look at him. Look at that guy. He's talking to his chat right now. Appreciate you sharing the live, too. Thank you so much. If you guys aren't following, hit that follow button. 528 people hanging out with me. It's awesome. There's a FootJoy. I want $7 for it. It's too expensive. There's two FootJoys in a row too. Damn, if they didn't want $7 for these, I'd probably pick them up. I'm probably gonna pass. $7 for FootJoy is a little too much. I could probably only get like 25 for those. Those are the newer labels too, but pass for me. That's a no, Scott. Morning. Chris, what? Chrisatpeak. 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 Like the peak of a mountain. He's on top. He's on top of the mountain. Just think of that. Older FootJoy better. Not really, but that's just too much for a FootJoy. I would normally pick that up. If that was like maybe $5, I'd pick it up. I know it's only a $2 difference, but that really hurts your margins. And I don't want to sit on anything for too long. There's a nice one. A little Travis Matthew for $6.99. Looks to be in good conditions. Got a nice pattern on the front, so we'll scoop that one up. Love picking up some Travy Matthew. Tommy Bahama, Brooks Brothers. Happy Tuesday. What's up, Stitch? Happy Tuesday. Travy Maddie. Maddie Travy. Home for the holiday. It's okay, you guys. Everybody can sing along. By the way, when I post this to YouTube, I'm 100% getting a copyright strike. getting a copyright notice as soon as I post this. I can smell it. I'll be like, yeah, you're playing too much cute Christmas music in the background. Like, my bad, it's not my fault. How many years have you done this? I've done this this is my fourth year of doing this. This is my first year full time. I pass Fashion Noble. I don't pick up Fashion Noble. So you get Ralph Lauren, only certain Ralph Lauren pieces. I'm gonna pass on the Southern Tide too. Looks too ratty. It's just a plain Southern Tide polo. You ever go to estate sales? No. I get enough inventory from thrift stores that I really don't have to go sourcing to anywhere else. Just pretty much thrift stores and retail stores where I get my inventory. This is another aisle with a really jam-packed aisle. Friday. What about Friday? I might go thrifting on Friday. Still up in the air. If you guys want me to go thrifting on Friday, I might do another live thrift at Red, White, and Blue. Still up in the air though. Looking for brands. Yep, brands with good resell value. Should I start reselling school? Should start a reselling school? Me? No. Why start a school when I got all the information right here on TikTok? Do it for free. I'm not into courses or anything like that. I'd rather give all the information out for free. Appreciate you guys hanging out too. We're up to almost 50,000 likes. We're up to almost 1,000 people in here. If you're not following, hit that follow button. I do this multiple times a week where I come to thrift stores. I show you guys what I pick up to buy and resell online. As you can see, I got a full cart right now. We've only been through about a quarter of the store. So we still got tons more to go. Appreciate everybody hanging out today. Where do you sell on? I sell on eBay, Poshmark, Mercari, Facebook Marketplace. If you're new here, hit the follow button and go through and watch some of my videos. I have tons of videos here on TikTok showing exactly what I do. I also have a YouTube channel where I post these live thrifts to. So if you like what you're watching right now, you can literally re-watch live thrifts. I've had hours and hours of content on YouTube right now. Just hit 1,000 followers or 1,000 subscribers on YouTube, so that was pretty awesome. I know I just passed the theory polo. I know people are gonna be like, go back. I don't pick up theory polos. That's where it's at. Yeah, I find a lot of good stuff on Facebook Marketplace, and I sell a decent amount of good stuff on Facebook Marketplace. Holy cow. My ears. Man, these polos have been really shit. There's a, is that a 4XB or is that 1XB? How much do I want for this? There's no price tag. There's no price tag on you. I probably want too much. If this was like $4.99, I'd pick it up, but I don't know what they want for it. It's a good size. It's a 1XB polo Ralph Lauren little pony logo. It's an awkward size, but it doesn't have a price, so I know what they're going to do. As soon as I bring it to the register, they're going to be like $7.99. Like, nah, I'm good. So I'll leave it behind. I think I just seen Osborne the Thrift in here. Wow. Osborne the Thrift? No, he doesn't. He doesn't live in my area. He lives, where does he live? He lives in one of the northern states, I believe. I'm in Florida. Is B for big? Yeah. It's, it means it's a wider shirt. It's like for a bigger guy. Big boned. Man, these have been, oh, there we go. There we go. Anybody out there working McDonald's? Got a shirt for you. People hanging out. If you're not following, hit that follow button top left hand corner. Go to the women's now? No, I don't need to go. I don't need to rush there because Chris doesn't do women's. So if you guys didn't know, Chrisatpeak is in the same store as I am right now. He's thrifting the other side. So I really don't got to worry about running over there. Chipotle shirt. There's another Chipotle shirt. Get this Smarters and Branson. Keep passing shirts worth money. Like what? What shirt have I passed that's worth money? You gotta remember, I'm paying like $6.99 for these shirts. So if these shirts are worth like $25, I ain't picking them up. Like these Nike shirts aren't worth anything. They're worth like maybe $10. Armani polos don't sell well. Go look up sold comps on eBay. It's a nice brand, but they don't have good resale. This. Isn't that the Nike? Isn't that a Nike? No. It looks like a Nike logo, but it can't be because it's got that little tag in the back. Thought that might have been an old Nike tag. You keep skipping $300 shirts. Yeah, I know. I should go back and get them all. I'm skipping all the good ones. Like Eddie Bauer. Eddie Bauer is a really good brand. It sells for $300. Bugatti Uomo. This is an excellent brand. It sells for $300. You should pick it up. No, they don't sell for $300. What state do you live in? I live in Florida. Flowrider. Banana Republic. Nautica. Bobby Jones. Look, it's got golfers on the front. It's got to be worth money. Pick it up. What are you doing, you stupid thrifter? Bugatti, wow. Yeah, I know. I don't pick up Bugatti polos unless they're like patterned polos. And those tend to do really good. Lacoste, look at that size. It's a size 3, which means it's an extra small. And they want $6.99 for it. It's too much. Too much for the Lacoste. What happened with the Burberry coat? Which one? The one that Big Al picked up? Big Al picked it up. He got that Burberry coat. Shout out Big Al. Big Al's dope. But Big Al got it, not me. Ooh, a little summer comfort. Looks to be in good condition. It does have a TPC logo on it. It wants $6.99. I'll probably still pick it up because it's a nice pink pattern. Even with this gaudy logo on it, it'll probably still sell for like $25. And it'll sell pretty quick because it's a summer comfort. So we'll scoop that up. I'll just have to make sure it doesn't have any stains on it. There's a Linksole polo. How much do they want for the Linksole polo? $6.99, damn. If this was $5, I'd probably, actually I wouldn't. Look at that stain. Look at that stain. Load up on chap shirts. Yeah, you could definitely load up on chap shirts if you really wanted to. And George, chaps and George. You get as many as you want in every thrift store. so many nice colors. Yeah, this is, they have some really nice shirts in Salvation Army. Shout out to all the people that say we steal from the poor and we're not leaving anything behind. Did you mean to pass the FootJoy Polo? Yeah, the FootJoy Polo, it was super ratty in the back, so that's why I passed it. I'm not going to pick up that either. Southern Tide Polos used to do well. Now they only sell for like 15 to 20, and they're a pretty hard sell at that. Southern Tide long sleeves are the ones you want to be on the lookout for. If you guys aren't following, make sure you hit that follow button. We're almost at the 50k likes. Let's get to 50k really quick. Everybody tap that screen. We only need a little bit more to get to 50k. Man, these shirts are so stuffed in here. Appreciate all those follows coming in. We're up to 51k likes. Let's go. Remember, if you guys are interested in watching somebody else in the same store as I am right now, Chrisatpeak is live right now. He's looks like he's in the short section, hanging out in the shorts. He's stealing all the stuff from the poor right now. Probably gonna go to the pants after this pants section. What brands are you looking for? I'm looking for brands with good resale value. That is a golden goat. This is a Players Club shirt with a golden goat on the front. I have a feeling this is worth some money because it's got a golden goat. I've never found a golden goat. There's another RLX shirt, $4.99. Let's go. That's got to be worth money, right? Somebody look that up. Just on a Players Club shirt, Golden Goat logo. I'm pretty sure that's worth a lot of money. I'm pretty sure. We'll get Chris's opinion. I don't know if Chris knows about the Golden Goat. Looks like an ISU shirt. I think I just found a Golden Goat. Golden Goat. Going for $100. Yep, that's what I figured. We just found a $100 shirt live in the thrift. Let's get a video of it because it might be on a TikTok later today. They want $10.99 for it, but it's worth picking up for $10.99. Golden Goat sold for $100. Let's go, let's go, Golden Goat, Golden Goat. I'm gonna have to keep that shirt actually because, you know, people call me the goat of men's shirts, so I might have to keep that one. Yeah, I'm gonna list mine for 101. Southern Marsh, almost a hit. Great condition, yeah, it is in super nice condition. The golden goat has been found. That's a legit golden goat. I still don't know if that Peter Millar is a golden goat. I still haven't listed it yet. Probably should look that up. I'll compare it to this one because this one is an actual golden goat. You can tell from the stitching that that's a good golden goat. Is he going for 100? Yep. That is what you guys are out there looking for. These are all the same right here. Skip over all those. I'll have to go brag to Chris. What will that golden goat shirt sell for? I think it's like a $100 shirt. Pretty sure that's a $100 shirt. It's a Players Club. If this was like a Peter Millar or a FootJoy or something like that with a golden goat, it'd be worth more. But yeah, it's still a good pickup. Where's Chris at? Chris disappeared. Oh, there he is. He's over here hiding. Let's get his opinion on it. Know what that is?
I don't think I do.
Players Club Golden Goat Polo. Damn. Let's go for like $100.
How about it?
Hey, buddy. Home run. Look at this. We're liveception right now. Liveception.
I don't think we're supposed to cross the stage. Is that your signature piece right now?
Yeah.
Nice, man.
Yeah, buddy. I think he's already been through this section, so let's go through the pants really quick. Not seen it on eBay. We'll look it up in a little bit. I'll let Chris take this. Let's go through these jackets. Let's see what they got on the money rack. I don't see anything on this money rack. Let's go through the pants. Who's on Posh? Is it a Millar? No, it's not a Peter Millar. It's just a Players Club Golden Goat. Let's go this way.
So I cleared
this over here.
I cleared big and tall everything.
Mm-hmm.
I cleared jeans.
Have you done pants?
I haven't done any of these pants. You see, I haven't done blazers.
Okay.
I'm assuming you got all these shirts over here.
Yeah, I did those. I haven't done those over there though. Yeah.
I'll probably go play over here.
Okay. All right. We're just marking our territory right now. Me and Chris, like, we pee on the, we're like dogs. We just pee on the corner of the racks, and we're like, this one's mine. I love shopping here. Yeah, this is a pretty good one. I've never been to this Salvation Army. Let's see what we can find in the pants section. Pants section sometimes can be really good. And we'll go over the women's. Maybe I'll do like half the pants and I'll leave the other half for Chris, and then I'll do go do the women's jeans. Do I sell suits? No, I don't sell any suits. BC clothing. Appreciate you guys hanging out. We got 1.6k people in here. If you aren't following, hit that follow button top left hand corner. It'll let you know when I go live. I do this multiple times a week where I go to thrift stores and retail stores. I show you what I pick up to buy and then sell online for a profit. So if you're interested, hit that follow button top left hand corner. And then go through some of my content after live too. I got tons of content here on TikTok showing sales, showing me pickup items, showing me pickup items and then showing sales afterwards. Lots of stuff. So feel free to give me a follow and then go through some of my stuff. Let me know how you like it. I might shoot over the women's section here pretty quick. I'm not seeing anything in the pants section. Dolce & Gabbana pants for $5. Hey, I just made a sale on eBay. Robert Graham shirt just sold. I don't know what it sold for though. I can't check. Are Bonobos Sunday pants. They want $8 for them. It's too much. I could tell that they were Bonobos right away. Here's a pair of Canali pants, $6.99. Size 40. They went with a suit. They're just a solid blue. Are these wool? Might pick these up if they're wool. Let me see. Where's the fabric tag in these? Somebody cut out the fabric tag? Supposed to say, oh, it might be right there. Do, 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 do. Doesn't say what these are made out of. How much they want? $6.99 for them, $7 for Canali pants. They look to be in good condition. I just sold a pair of Canali pants for $25 today, so I might keep those. Might put them back. We'll see. Pass. Yeah, I just sold a pair for $25 today. I had a list for $35, and they sold pretty quick. So now's the time of year people are picking up like nice dress pants and stuff like that for their Christmas parties and their get-togethers. So I might pick that one up. Canali's a really good brand. Those pants like retailed for probably like $150 to $200. And what are you looking for in pants without looking at the brand? So most like high-end brands will have the label. Like this is not a high-end brand, but most high-end brands will have like this. I'm also, I'll go through and if I see something that looks high quality, I'll feel it really quick to see if it's like a silk or if it's wool. But really I'm just like peeking. Pants are pretty hard to look through because some high-end pants have the actual maker like way down in the pant. So sometimes you miss good stuff. But this is one of the sections of the thrift store where people pass often. people don't look through the pants section. And this is where the money is made. Found a pair of GoRuck pants the other day at Salvation Army for $6, and those go for $100. Line pants are nice, yep. I think I'm gonna finish with this aisle. I'm gonna leave the rest for Chris. I'm gonna go hit the women's jean section, see what we can find. I'll skim through this one really quick. All right, let's hit the women's. Oh, they have a short section too. Ooh, I might actually do the shorts really quick. This is gonna be pretty hard to show though on stream. Yeah, it's gonna be pretty hard to show on stream, but I need to go through the shorts really quick. They have a ton of shorts here. Adidas. What are you, English Laundry? Appreciate the follows. 1.5k people hanging out. If you guys aren't following, hit that follow button. Top left-hand corner. Sorry, I'm trying to show the labels, but this is like super tight in here. Maybe I'll come back to the shorts just for video purposes. Robert Graham 2XL tailored shirt sold for $35. Let's go. Bam. That's why you go through the shorts. This is why you go through the shorts, people. That's why you go through the shorts. Easy money. Easy money. Okay, we're staying at the shorts now. I can't leave. I can't leave the shorts. Lulus. Those Lululemon shorts, $6-7 I think they were. And those will go for like $35 to $40, and they'll sell pretty quick. What was it? There were Lululemon men's shorts. So that's why you go through the shorts section. Because you can find some Lululemons just hanging out. There's Adidas right there. Lulus, those are Bonobos, I believe. Yep, Bonobos. $5. I'm gonna pass on the Bonobos. Oh man, this kills my back though. Lulus. What'd you say? Lulu brand is racist, it's trash. Well, mute. Bye bye. Man, some people just have nothing better to do with their lives. No pain, no gain. Exactly. I'm getting down on one knee now. I'm really dedicated to this short section. Chris is gonna video me while I'm on one knee. He's gonna be like, what the hell is this guy doing? He's gonna catch me live right now. Down on one knee. Like, look at this short section, and I missed half of it already. Ooh. Paper brand denim, fried denim. That one fell down. Oh, that one doesn't want to stay. He's going to catch you stealing from the poor. He will. No pain, no gain, Felix says. You know it's a good day when you found Lululemon. Too bad they're not my size. PKEs, I'll pass on those. Now it's pretty hard to see the labels, everybody, but there's no way I can show any better than this. It's kind of like in the bottom corner. Appreciate you guys hanging out though. If you're not following, hit that follow button top left hand corner. have to go back and hit the beginning of the shorts too. Friend, are you? Go grab my cart really quick. Since the Lulus are just like sitting on top, just chilling. Can we see the Lulus? Yeah. They're just a pair of Lululemon men's shorts. $6.99, and they were easy to spot because they still had the hang tag in them. Easy to spot. Easy work. Let's go through the jean shorts too. I don't know if Chris has been over here yet. Man, there's so much junk around here. Like, this thing is just hanging up. Let's see if we get some Rock Revival jean shorts. That would be nice. Rugged Outdoor Chino from Columbia for $7.99. It's brand new. I might actually pick that up. I don't normally pick up Columbia. What size is it, though? 42. I might pick it up. If I don't pick it up, I might give it to Chris. See if he wants it. Okay, nothing else in the short section. We'll come back. There's somebody else right now in the other side of the shorts. Let's go to the women's jeans. Where is the women's jeans? This store is massive. There's some jeans down here, I see. See what we got for women's jeans. Actually, I gotta go from this side. See some vintage Ralph Lauren right off the bat. Which I want for these. $10 for those? Nah, I am paying $10 for them. Wait, which way do these jeans go? Which way do these jeans go? I guess they do go this way. Maybe the first couple are the wrong way. There we go. Easy money. Rag and Bone women's jeans for $10. Right off the rip, we found a pair of Rag and Bone. Let's go. Yeah. What's up, Sonia? I didn't even see you pop in here, Sonia. How are you doing today, Miss Sonia? Wash new, used clothes before you wheat. What? It's too bad these are too expensive. I might actually pick these up because that's got a big flag hit on the back. It might be worth picking up. If they want $10 for it, I'm going to pass. What's the most expensive stuff you found? I found tons of expensive stuff. My eBay store is linked in my bio. All the used items that are in my store right now are items that I found at thrift stores. Go check it out. eBay store is linked in my bio. Ralph Lauren would sell Depop or Grailed. Well, Sonia, unfortunately, I don't sell on either of those platforms. Sold on those platforms, I might pick it up, but your boy doesn't sell on Depop and Grailed. Maybe next year I am going to probably switch over to Depop and Grailed and sell at least one of them, probably Grailed. But for now, I'll leave it behind. Somebody else can have it. Are these Diesel? Diesel jeans for? I want $10. I'll probably pass on those. Too expensive. $10 for diesel. It's way too expensive. Way too expensive. And those were a really small size too. Those were like a size like 24. Been doing this, you mean today or for my entire thrifting career? I've been reselling for 4 years. I've been in this store for 1 hour and 7 minutes. Actually, I've been in the store for 1 hour because Chris was 7 minutes late. So, yeah. Thanks, Chris. Man, why are these all backwards? They're like backwards and forwards, and they're hard to show on camera when they're all messed up. Don't they know I was gonna be here today? Hello. All right, let's go to the next rack. Oh, your life? Yeah, 4 years. 4 years I've been buying stuff from thrift stores and reselling them online for a profit. Bin had polo. I don't know what you meant by that, but I've been had polo. And come on, I was hoping that, like, you know, once I found like one rag and bone jean, I would find like three or four like right after it. But you know, that only happens to certain resellers, not me. On average, how much do you bring in per year? Last year I made $54,000 profit, and that was part-time. I'm now a full-time reseller. I do this full-time. I've been full-time. You got a phone mount thing? No, I'm just holding the phone in front of me. You know, like those annoying people that scream at their phones while they're like walking around stores? That's like basically what I look like right now, except I'm not screaming in my phone. A pair of Paige women's jeans, but these are super faded and they're super stretched. What brands do you look for? Brands with good resale value. Looking for brands with good resale value. If you want to know the brands I pick up on a consistent basis, my eBay store is linked in my bio. You can go check out my eBay store and see what I currently have listed. And those are going to be the brands that I am currently looking for. That's incredible. Thank you. You're incredible. And I appreciate you for being here. By the way, Chris is in the store too. So if you guys want to check out another reseller who is currently thrifting in the same store as me, Chrisatpeak is in the store. You gotta just go over to his channel and watch him. What size are you? You might be worth picking up if you're a decent size. Yep, 30R. These, they are $10, but they're a really good size and they're really good distressing. So I'm probably gonna pick these up. These are women's AG jeans, size 30. I'll probably be able to sell these for 35 pretty quick. And right behind it is another pair. These are the older style. These are an older style. I'm gonna look this style up and see if it's worth it, but this is also AG jeans. It's probably another 35. Do you use Pirate Ship? Yeah, when I sell on Facebook and I sell on Mercari, I use Pirate Ship. Sometimes I use Pirate Ship for my eBay labels, but most of the time I just use eBay for those labels. I wish they didn't price those up so high. I wonder if that's half off too. There's gotta be colors that are half off today. They normally run at least one color half off every day. Jerbo's my favorite jeans. Yeah, I'm old. Jerbo jeans actually sell really well. I've only found them very few times and they sold very fast for very good money. So I'd be very happy if I found Jerbo jeans right now. Just had to continue the very thing going. Chris cleaned out all the good jeans. Not in this area, no. Chris doesn't do women's. So this is my safe zone. Like, You know when you're playing tag and you got like a safe zone where nobody can tag you in? Like that's pretty much where I'm at right now. Chris can't tag me over here. Chris would walk over here and he would be lost. I'm safe. Can't tag me. I'm safe. Now, did you see those Levi's? Yeah, but they're too expensive. Women's Levi's don't even sell as close as well as men's do, and they're too expensive here. They're like, most Levi's are like $10 in the store from what I've seen, so I'll pass. What jeans are you looking for? Jeans with good resell value. There's tons of brands I am currently on the lookout for. Rock Revival, Miss Me, not Mech Denim. I don't pick up mech. Mech is meh. I picked up Rag & Bone so far. I picked up two pairs of AG jeans so far in the women's section. For the men's section, I picked up a pair of 7 for All Mankind jeans, and I picked up, I haven't found this brand in, might still sell with that bleach stain. Sometimes jeans don't matter if they have bleach stains on them. I'll take that into account, $10, but this is a good brand, Mott & Bow. I haven't found that brand in like a year, and I found it twice in the same week. Mott & Bow. You miss Raffaello? Is that a good brand? I have no clue. I'm not an expert in women's by any means. Do they have a shoe section? Yeah, I've already been through the shoes. I picked up a pair of Allbirds and a couple other shoes. I got them in the bottom of my cart. We'll go over everything in my cart once I get done thrifting. My cart's over there. It's like massive. Did you just pass Mother Jeans? I hope not. Are you guys distracting me? I'm passing Mother Jeans? I don't think I did. You ever pick up True Religion? I pick up True Religion men's, but I do not pick up True Religion women's. I don't think I passed Mother Jeans. Please don't tell me I did that. I'll go back and look through the whole rack if I did. Aw, Bearded's in the house. You see that? He gives me a little heart. Thanks, Beardy bro. Bearded, Chris is here with me. Jake Jill. You're going too fast. I just saw a small tag. I don't think I did. I was looking at the tags. I hope not. I really hope not. Now it's going to haunt me later tonight when I'm going to sleep. I'm like, did I really pass a pair of Mother Jeans? And I'm going to rewatch this live and I'm going to see myself pass it. And I'm going to drive here tomorrow. How old are you? I am 30 years young. How old does my hand look? I'm so stupid. Oh my God, I'm so stupid. All right, we're going to pick up these Mott & Bow. Even though they got a small, it's a good brand. It's too bad they're bleached. I might actually pass. Mott & Bow is a really good brand. These are women's. You know what? I'm going to put it back. It's too bad of a bleach stain on those. That's too sad. That's so sad. Because that's a really good brand. You are so talented? Really? This is talent? Man. What have I been doing my whole life? I should have been practicing this since I was younger. Thank you for the compliment, though. I mean that in the sincerest way. How dare you steal a full cart from the poor? I know. Like, how dare I steal this whole cart from the poor? Bearded, you're right. How dare I? That Karen would be upset with me right now. She wouldn't be upset that I left all of this behind. I'm gonna use this for one of my videos, by the way. Next person that says I steal from the poor, I'm gonna use that little clip. By the way, everybody, Bearded is just kidding. He steals from the poor too. We steal from the poor together. So don't get mad at Bearded. You should go follow him. Because he's right up here. You should go follow Bold North and you should go follow Bearded. They're both excellent resellers. They do the same thing as me. They go to thrift stores and they steal from the poor. Another pair of AG jeans, Tomboy, bigger size. Is that another pair right there too? Wow. This was half off day. This would be a lot better. There's another pair. These are Primas. What size are they though? What size is this? I think they cut out the size tag actually. I'm gonna look up at the end. I'll look up what size they are. If they're too small, I'll leave them behind. They gotta be like 30 or bigger. Otherwise I'll leave them. I thought my purchase was a donation. It is. You're right. You win. You won the pop quiz. You passed the test. What size women's jeans do you pick up? I try to pick up like 29 and bigger. They just sell better for me. I don't have like a curated women's store, so I gotta buy the women's stuff that sells fast. If I had like a bunch of women's clothing, I'd probably pick up basically everything, but I only have a little bit of women's. Man, I hate how they do this. They got like half of them one way, half of them another way. AE sells well, yeah, but not when I'm paying $9.99 for jeans. It's not enough meat on the bone. By the way, what brand was that? Catherine something?
Yeah, Tate said he's going to the southern one that we went to, the Christmas show.
Done with women's jeans. Let's find the sweater section. This store is a freaking mess. Actually, there's more jeans over here. Holy cow. There's another rack of jeans right here. How do they have these situated though? Do they have them this way? They have them this way, I guess. Hey, Bearded. Bearded. I always find your favorite brand every time I come here. I think these are the plus sizes, I believe. Big sizes. I gotta be careful with what I say. I can't say like large sizes. I'll offend some people. Do you ever go to Ross? Not really. Been in Ross before, but I don't go there very often anymore. Pick up vintage Calvin Klein. It's here if you want it. Alright, let's look. Let's look for the sweaters. We already been through the shoes already once. I have no clue where the sweaters are here. I'm lost. This is a maze. Where are the sweaters? Somebody tell me where the sweaters are. Maybe the store doesn't, oh, there it is. There's somebody there though. Oh, they have more shoes up here too? Man. All right, let's park our cart. Let's go look at these shoes over here. I haven't looked at these at all. North side. Got a bunch of shoes. I think I saw a pair that I want to look at. Oh, I thought those were Birkenstocks. Damn it. Rip off Birkenstocks. All right, where did I park my cart? There it is. Let's go find Chris.
Huh? Well, that's what I go to anyway.
Let's go find Chris. There's a lady in the what do you call it? The sweater section. I don't want to film next to her. So let's go to the shorts really quick. We haven't been through these shorts down here. I already found a pair of Lulu shorts here. Let's see if we can find another pair of Lulus. Thrift store is this? The Salvation Army. This is the first time I've ever been in the Salvation Army. It's massive. Make sure everybody hanging out. If you're not following, hit that follow button top left-hand corner. I do this multiple times a week. Come to thrift stores, show you guys what I pick up to resell online for a profit. Not seeing any more Lulus. These are illegal to sell, by the way. These are post office pants. You're not allowed to sell these. Post office shorts. Not seeing anything here. There's a couple more up here I can go through. Lots of REI here. Too bad REI doesn't sell. Florida Gators, Columbia. Sorry, I'm trying to show the labels, but this is like super stuffed in here. Columbia. Nothing. All right, where's Chris? Chris is over here in the suit jacket section. You guys want to go over everything I found? Best I find so far was probably the golden goat polo. I'm assuming that's a $100 polo. I gotta look it up after the live. All right, let's go over everything and we'll probably head off. Actually, the one section I didn't check out is the pants. Let's do the pants really quick, sorry. I didn't do these pants over here. I don't know if Chris did, but we'll go through them really quick. Then we'll go over everything. I'm keeping you guys in suspense right now. What are you looking for? I'm looking for brands with good resale value. So Vineyard Vines, $7.99. Too expensive. Skim through this real fast. Wrangler, Cherokee. Polo Ralph Lauren. Brand are you? By the way, if you guys want to watch somebody else do this, Mr. at Peak is right there. He's on live right now, Chris at Peak. Here's a pair of Men's Joe's jeans. I'll pick these up. Depending on the price, again, there's no price, but I'll probably pick these up either way. These are nice khaki pants. These will sell pretty well. Pick those up. Don't forget about the sweaters. I'm not going to go back for the women's sweaters. There's a lady over there, and she's just, like, taking her sweet time, and I don't want to film right next to her, so I'll probably just leave. I'll probably just leave the sweaters. I'm already pretty full on the amount that I have right now. I gotta leave some more for all the poor people, right? I can't take everything from the poor. Are these legit? Are these legit? Are these legit? I don't know how to tell fake Prada from real Prada. Somebody tell me. No, not legit. Yeah, this button looks a little sus. Show the stitches. I can show the stitching on the inside. And then the label. Whoops. I can't Google it. I'm on the phone. Stitches 2. Vintage but real. Is it vintage? I can't Google this. Obviously, I'm on the phone. I'm too poor. Homeless tell fake. There's nothing else on the inside. Actually, this button actually feels a little heavyweight. That's the label. Where was it made? It says Prada, Milano. Now let me put down the phone for a second. Stay. Oh, I guess I can't make it stay. Trying to see this tag. This tag is like stuck. Doesn't have like a made in anywhere tag in it. Might be worth just the gamble. Might be worth the gamble to pick this up. Maybe I'll have Chris look at it. Any other tags? No. Prada Milano. Yeah, this is it's the interior tag right there. I don't see any other tag. You wanna look at it?
Check the R and the A.
Is that?
So it should be thinner with a little bump.
Okay, so that's fake.
Yeah.
Appreciate you. Look at that. Those are real. He said they're fake. I'll trust his opinion because I have no clue. For Pride is a nice designer. It is, but these are fake. Shout out to that guy. Yep. Shout out to him. I would still get it. I'm not gonna take the chance. I'll leave it. He already did his research, obviously, because he was over here. If they were legit, they would be in his cart, not mine. So those are fake. Yeah, stitching looks bad. It's hard to tell on used items about stitching because obviously somebody could have worn the stitching out. But yeah, shout out to him. Shout out to him for saving my life. Saved my life. He saved me $10. He's come back later. No, he already looked them up because he saw I was looking at him and then he popped back around, so he knows his stuff. What is this? What are you? Oh, a Cremex. All right, let's go over everything I found. Ask him if he resells, new friend. I will on the way out. Are you in Miami? No, I'm in I am in Tampa Bay right now. All right, I gotta find a spot where I'm not gonna like hog a whole area. I guess right here is fine. We'll go over everything I picked up and then we'll probably head to the next store. All right, first pickup, these are Joe's jeans. I don't know how much they are because there's no tag on them. Men's Joe's jeans do pretty good. Probably like $35 for those. I got a bunch of these women's AG jeans. I'm paying $10 a piece, but they all look to be in good sizes, like right around 30. There's another one right there. There's another one right there. There's another one right there. And then we got a pair of Rag & Bones for $10. Actually, we're gonna pass on these. Look at that. Look at that hole. Those are a pass. Why would they even try to sell these for $10? Like, come on. Come on. How much for those AG jeans? I'm probably gonna list them for like 35. This is Columbia, $7.99. It's brand new with tags. I'll either pick these up or I'll give them to Chris. New ventilation, yeah. Alright, one of my favorite finds of the day. Always love when I find some Lululemon. $7 men's Lululemon shorts. Probably gonna pass on these Canalis. I'm just gonna pass on them. I don't really feel like dealing with them. I gotta look this up. This is a Players Club Golden Goat polo. If this is legit and everything's good with it, it's probably like around $100. Really good find. RLX, $4.99. I might pass on it just because of that embroidery. Actually, I probably am. What size is it though? It's a big size. I might keep it. It's a size XL. I'll pass. I'm gonna pass on that one. Here, let me put it right here. I'll put it away once I'm done. This one does have a logo on it too. It's a Peter Millar Summer Comfort. But it's actually $7. I might pass on this one too. I'll put it off to the side. Might pass on that one. This one I'm for sure not gonna pass on. This is a Travis Matthew, $7. These normally go for like 35 pretty quick on Facebook Marketplace. I gotta look up comps on these Buzz Off shirts. They're $7. I think I can sell these for like 25 to 30 pretty quick. Golden Goat, didn't know about that one. Yeah, it's something you need to be on the lookout for. This is a Woolrich chamois, $8, heavy duty, but I'm gonna pass. I just noticed this. It's got a hole, so we're gonna pass on that one. Let's put those on the back of my cart. We'll put those up. Another Buzz Off, $7. Another Buzz Off, $7. This is a Brooks Brothers solid white dress shirt. As long as there's no stains, I'll pick it up. I gotta look it over thoroughly, see if there's any stains on it. Another one I gotta look up. Helly Hansen long sleeve shirt. They want $8 for it. Gotta look up comps and see if it's worth picking up. No, the Travis Matthew isn't stained. It's a shadow. It was a shadow. It's not stained. Let's see what else we got. I gotta look this one up after I'm done. I've never seen a Joseph A. Bank. 100% silk Joseph A. Bank Hawaiian shirt. So I'm gonna look this one up, see if it's worth picking up. So how to research price, you just look on eBay at sold comps. Vineyard Vines size medium for $7. Normally get like 35 for those. I am paying up for this. This is a pair of Carhartt jeans. The logo's right there on the back. These have been selling really quick for me for like $35, so I'm gonna pick it up. 36, size 36, really good one. And the last pair of clothing that I'm gonna pick up is a pair of 7 for All Mankind, straight, $7.99. You see, there's like a little bit of pilling on the front. I'm probably gonna pass on these actually. There's too much pilling right there. You see how much wear that is? So we're gonna pass on those. All right, so for shoes, we got a pair of Zero Grand Cole Haans. There's no price, so I gotta see what they're pricing these at. Yeah, they don't have a price on these. They do look a little worn too. We'll see what they want for those. Pair of Allbirds. These used to sell really well. I gotta look up comps, see how much they've dropped. But these are just a normal pair of Allbirds for $13. If these go for like 35 plus shipping, I might pick them up. But I don't know where Allbirds prices are right now. Haven't found a pair in forever. They look to be in pretty good condition. And these are a pass. Somebody already looked these up and I just threw them in the cart. So I got a pass on those. Pretty good haul. Pretty good haul. Cheese grater works too. Yeah, it's not worth it. I'll just pass for now. I gotta look up, I gotta go through all of these, make sure they're all in good condition, and then we'll throw them in the cart. Favorite find of the day has to be this. I love when I find Lululemon. Use a sweater shaver. Yeah, I could. I could, but it's not worth it, to be honest. All right. Let's flip the camera. See, if you guys have any last minute questions, you can leave them in chat, and then I will, I'm gonna head off and go through my pile really quick. Let's go. I guess we'll stay here. We'll stay here, because I gotta go through the pile. Appreciate 65K likes. Let's go. Where is he? I'm in Salvation Army. Joseph A's is 16 on eBay. Yeah, I'm going to look it up, see, make sure. Appreciate the follows. Which was Lululemon? I got a pair of Lululemon shorts for $7. I want to learn. If you want to learn, go through some of my videos. Give me a follow. Go through some of my videos. I have tons of videos here on TikTok. How to spot Lululemon shorts. Let's see. Where are they at? There they are. So when you're looking for Lululemon, I have a video on this, but I'll go over it really quick. Button's a dead giveaway. When you see that shiny button, that's a dead giveaway. But this one was even more of a dead giveaway because it still has the little hang tag in it. So hang tag has a Lululemon logo right there on top. And then if it doesn't have the hang tag still, you're just looking for that silver button. And then you'll look all over the piece and see where the logo is. Where's the logo on this one? Right there. There's a logo on the bottom. They're really hard to spot. That's why thrift stores always miss them. You can also look on the inside. And there's always a little rivet on the inside. And there's a Lululemon logo right there. So that's how you spot Lululemon. All right. I'm gonna go ahead and head off. If you missed this live, it will be posted to my YouTube channel later today, so feel free to go watch it later today, probably like around like 7 o'clock tonight. I'll have it up on my YouTube. So appreciate you guys hanging out. Peace out, catch you on the next one.